tampons, my face is back. First, the big question, the one on everyone's mind. What is prosopagnosia? Prosopagnosia actually comes from two Greek words. Prosopon is for face, and agnosia means ignorance or non-recognition. So put them together and what have you got? The inability to recognize faces. Not quite as fun as bibbidi-bobbidi-boo. Now, prosopagnosia doesn't exactly roll off the tongue, so many people, including my friends and myself, just call it face blindness. Okay, so we've established what prosopagnosia is. Here are some things that it's not.
Oh, I don't remember names either.
Oh, have you tried yoga?
Oh, I know a really good chiropractor. Yeah, but you, like, recognized me yesterday.
Wait, so you don't remember me at all?
So you can't see my face.
While face blindness is a recognized disorder, it can vary from person to person and even situation to situation. It's not an issue with vision, a difficulty with names, or even absent-mindedness. It's simply trouble with physical recognition. For our purposes today, recognition and memory are different, which I will clarify in a later video. But for now, memory is the thoughts, opinions, and past experiences you've logged in your mind, whereas a face is the key to accessing them. It's kind of like scrambling through your pockets and looking for your house key, except all of your keys look the same. Oh, and people watching this in the future, a key is something that you stick in a door, and people in the far future, a door is something. Though both have been offered to me as legitimate suggestions, there is currently no evidence implying that yoga or chiropractic treatment has any effect on face blindness. While laughable, it is almost forgivable due to the lack of what's available online or in the media. I'll be going over how it's portrayed throughout this series, but they range from this to this. While each are helpful in their own way, most examples are not very reliable for a self-diagnosis, so instead I found these to be much more accurate in portraying what face blindness is really like. Or if we're being cute, I'll be touching on a self-diagnosis in a couple of episodes. I have a couple of sections I'll be introducing to the show as we go along. Today's new section is called Good to Know, but you already knew that. It's a stupid title card. Anyway, according to the CDC, as of March of 2014, autism is found in 1 out of every 68 people. Prosopagnosia is conservatively estimated to be about 2% of the population, or 1 in every 50 people. So let me say this again. According to this information, face blindness is more prevalent than autism. Good to know, right? FYI, if you're in the London area, the London Face Blind Group's upcoming meeting times are going to be listed below. Check them out right now. I will try to keep them up to date, but if you don't see them, it means that they're actually being updated on a much newer video, or the Vash and Arada have actually claimed the underside of my bed as their new home, and I'm now a pile of bones. I'll let you Google that one. Alright, Panans, that's all for today. A huge shout out to Logan, my new director, for helping me with this, and like his entire family. To everyone watching, feel free to like or subscribe, the usual YouTube stuff. Feed me comments, questions, or concerns, because I'm so hungry for them. And I'm also on Twitter, Tumblr, and Facebook, so don't be shy. Remember, you're all anonymous to me. See you next time. You'll know it's me, I'll just have to assume it's you.